So we are continuing the lesson doping, and the topic that we will discuss today is responsibilities of an athlete. So responsibilities of athlete, there are various responsibilities of athletes regarding anti-doping policies formed by the WADA. There should be no violation of code by the athlete. Other various responsibilities are there for an athlete, that the athlete is responsible for these, are the responsibilities of the athlete. So first is to be aware and comply with all anti-doping policies. Second is to be available for sample collection at all time, as some athlete takes like doses of EPO between two standard timings of sample collection. To be responsible for ingest and use of any substance or method in context of anti-doping. To inform medical personnel of the team about any medical treatment taken and confirming that it does not violate anti-doping policies. To report immediately to doping control station for testing unless delayed for valid reason. To maintain control of the sample until it's sealed. So the various responsibilities in the context of doping. There are several other responsibilities of the athlete, like fair play, always should promote fair play, and they must follow the rules and regulations of the sports. They must be a role model for the society, and they should not involve in any kind of illegal activities, because in society many people follow the sports celebrities. So the sports persons have various responsibilities. Personal responsibilities are different, but they have a lot of social responsibilities. Performance related responsibilities, like performance in sports, because when the sports person are representing their country, so then they have to perform for their country, for the people of the country. So the responsibilities of athletes are a lot. Here we are discussing the responsibilities of athletes in context with of the doping. Now we will come to the another topic, that is side effects of prohibited substances. So we have studied the substances which are prohibited in sports. Now their side effects. First is anabolic steroids. The cardiovascular effect, elevate blood pressure and decrease high density lipoprotein, HDL. So HDL is considered good for good cholesterol, and LDL is considered dangerous cholesterol. So the anabolic steroids decrease the high density lipoprotein. it increases the risk of atherosclerosis. It may lead to sudden cardiac death. Means it affects the cardiovascular system highly. Endocrine effect. It increases aggressiveness, which may lead to criminal behavior. Now we can see then how endocrinal effect lead aggressiveness, because aggressiveness is related to the hormones that is secreted from the adrenal gland. That hormone is responsible for making the person aggressive. So that's why the hormonal system, when is affected, then the person may be aggressive. So endocrine effect is there, increase aggressiveness, which may lead to criminal behavior. Males become impotent, that is infertility. Physical appearance change and become well. So that is infertility. Next one, the female endocrinal effect. Female become muscular, endocrinal effect in the female, then we have studied in previous slide in the male. Female become muscular, excessive hair growth, deepening of voice changes, imbalance of female hormones. So another one is the cause liver tumor and cancer and jaundice. So this is endocrinal effect of the anabolic steroids. These are the side effect we are studying, side effect of prohibited substances. Psychological effect of the anabolic steroid: mood swing, aggression, depression, withdrawal from the problem of dependence on other person. So these are the side effects of the anabolic steroids. Next we will see, then this we have studied, so we will see the stimulant. Stimulant increases heart rate and palpitation, causes insomnia, that is the problem of, that is sleeping disorder, sleeping problem. Person are unable to take proper sleep, causes insomnia, anxiety, aggressiveness, dehydration and heart failure. So these are the side effects of the stimulant. Loss of judgment power, indecisiveness. So that is known as the loss of judgment power. Narcotic, side effect of the narcotic, causes loss of balance and coordination, loss of balance, loss of concentration, false sense of security and power. The people feel that is false sense is there in mind, that they are powerful, they are secure. So that's why when the people use narcotics, so then they feel then they are highly secure. That's why they do not have any fear and they think that they are so powerful. That is the false sense. Cause nausea, drowsiness, vomiting, constipation, fainting, and coma. This can lead coma situation also. That is, the coma is the situation when the nervous system does not respond. Highly addictive, and this cause addiction also. Narcotic cause addiction. Highly addictive and causes withdrawal symptoms when stopped. Withdrawal symptoms means when the persons are addicted and they want to leave the narcotic. So then after leaving it, there are various problems arises in body because withdrawal symptoms are also there. When they stop taking narcotic, then in their body a lot of withdrawal symptoms are there. So these are the side effects of the narcotics. We will go to the next one, that is peptide hormones that we have discussed. Peptide hormones are the hormones used for growth and development. So the side effects are there. So especially EPO, erythropoietin, it causes the thickening of the blood. It increases the blood density. So dense blood is very difficult to circulate in different parts of the body and especially upper body parts. And the dense blood does not carry sufficient nutrients and the demand, the requirement of the body. Transportation ability also affected. Increased risk of heart attack and pulmonary embolism. Another one, human growth hormone, HGH, that is human growth hormone that we have discussed. The side effect of this peptide hormone, when we are taking it from outside, causes overgrowth of limb and face. With age, muscles become weak. In older age, the muscles become weak, that I have discussed that time. When the muscles are growing by taking some substance from outside, so then that demand of these muscles cannot be fulfilled by the rest of the physiological system of the body. So in older age, later age, the muscles become weak and it causes serious problem. Increased sweating. It causes musculoskeletal changes, enlargement of heart, headache, joint pain, etc. Insulin, the peptide hormone, insulin causes low blood sugar, weakness, shortness of breath, brain damage, and death. So these are the side effects of peptide hormones. We will see then, next is beta 2 agonist. The side effects of the prohibited substances, beta 2 agonist, side effect of beta 2 agonist, prolonged use cause trembling of hand, feet, headache, risk of cardiac arrest. That is, cardiac arrest means heart attack. The side effect of diuretics, the diuretic which was being used by the athletes to lose weight and increase the urination by increasing the urine formation. So the side effect of diuretics causes dehydration, which can seriously affect the health, lead to mineral imbalance, muscle weakness, irregular heartbeat, and low blood pressure. Another side effect is sodium and potassium are decreased in body, which caused the damage of kidney. So these are the side effects of diuretics. Then we will see about the glucocorticoids. Glucocorticoids, the side effect of glucocorticoids are prolonged use causes weak tendons, torn muscles, high blood sugar, slow healing of wound, sodium and water retention leading to weight gain and edema means that is the edema means that is when the fluid is formed in body. So sodium and water retention leading to weight gain and edema, physical dependence and chronic fatigue. Because glucocorticoids also affect highly the pancreas, they also affect the formation of insulin in body. Cannabinoids, side effect of cannabinoids, these derivatives of cannabis sativa, reduces concentration and coordination because they directly affect our central nervous system. Reduces lung capacity leading to poor endurance, cause heart disease and lung cancer. So these are the side effects of cannabinoids. Overall we can see here then about the side effect of various prohibited substances and the effect side effects. Anabolic steroids increase muscle mass and strength, this is the effect, and minor complications are there. What are the minor complications? Because anabolic steroid that we have discussed, the effect is that used for muscle mass, increasing the muscle mass and strength. This is the effect. And second, we will discuss about minor complications. And third, we will discuss about more severe complication, means the side effect. Minor complications and major complications are both side effects. Effect and side effect. So anabolic steroid, the effect is increased muscle mass and strength. So the minor complications of anabolic steroids, male and female hormonal imbalance, and the major more severe complications, that is heart and liver diseases. Corticosteroids, so glucocorticosteroids also, this is known as corticosteroids, this is used for increased aggressiveness, reduce fatigue and pain, delay the feeling of pain, this is the effect. And their minor complications are there in body, retarded healing or foster infections, person is prone to infections and it delay the healing process. The severe complications are there, the damage kidney, pituitary gland, then diuretic, the effect of diuretic is reduces weight quickly and mask other drugs, they evade the other drugs. So this is the effect, the minor complications in the body, dehydration, cramps, loss of sodium and potassium in body, which leads to the kidney failure. And the major complications are there, palpitation and increases, heart rate increases, and there are major complications can be seen in heart attack, and kidney failure. Stimulant. The effect of stimulants increases alertness and delay fatigue because they make the body alert. So alertness increases alertness and delay the fatigue. So the minor complications are there of stimulant: restlessness and anxiety, palpitations, irregular breathing. So palpitations increases and irregular breathing. So the major complications are there: erratic heartbeats and severe palpitations of heart, and sometime it leads to cardiac arrest. Narcotics, these are analgesic, these are used as painkiller. So the side effects of narcotic, the effect of narcotics, these are painkillers to kill pain and reduce feeling of calm and induce the feeling of calm, means the person remain painless. So minor complications are there: aggravation of injuries and coma. Then major complications, more severe complications are there: slow breathing and dangerous for the brain and other about physiological functions. Beta blockers, these are also, the effect of the beta blockers are slow heart rate and steady body movement. Causes, the minor complications are there: causes asthma, decreases mental alertness, and the side effects are there: heart rate is severely slowed down. So these are the side effects of the various prohibited substances which we have discussed. Now we will discuss about the another topic, that is ergogenic aids. Ergogenic aid definition. Ergogenic aid are the substances or devices or practices that enhance the individual's energy use, energy production and recovery. Means ergogenic aid means these are used for, like we have discussed, various drugs and various substances and various methods. So in the same way, the ergogenic aids are, these are the substances, these may be substances, these may be devices, these may be practices that enhance the individual's energy consumption, energy use, energy production and recovery of the body. So these are also used to get the desired change in the body. Stretching and weight training are physical ergogenic aids. Like example, stretching and weight training are physical ergogenic aids. Visualization and hypnosis are mental ergogenic aids. Lighter weight running shoes and better designed golf clubs are mechanical ergogenic aids. So the ergogenic aids which are used to get the desired change, desired result, physically, psychologically, whatever the desired result or change we need, so we use the ergogenic aids. But perhaps the most commonly recognized form of ergogenic aids is the dietary supplement. So people use the dietary supplements to bring change in their physical and psychological health. So that's why the ergogenic aids are there. These are substances, devices, practices which enhance an individual's energy use, production and recovery. They also affect the growth and development of the body also. Definitely they affect the growth and development of the body. So there are various type of ergogenic aids we will discuss here. So ergogenic aids and their types. Psychological ergogenic aid that we will discuss. Ergogenic aids and their types. Psychological ergogenic aid, mechanical ergogenic aids, pharmacological. Pharmacological is the word used where the medicines and the drugs and medicines are formed. That is known as pharmacology, the study of medicines and drugs and their effect. Pharmacological ergogenic aids, physiological ergogenic aids, and nutritional ergogenic aids. So we will discuss these in details. So first we are discussing about the psychological ergogenic aids. Psychological aid. This is hypnosis. The induction of the state of consciousness. Hypnosis is that is the in which we induce the person's consciousness, in which a person apparently loses the power of voluntary action and is highly responsive to suggestion or direction. So this is a kind of powerful motivation, we can say, hypnosis, in which the person, it affects the person's consciousness and the person loses the voluntary action, the power of the voluntary action. Means voluntary action means that is controlled by our will. So the gradually the person loses the power of voluntary action and start following the suggestions and direction given by the person who is there for the hypnosis, to hypnotize. So hypnosis is clear. So this is a kind of powerful motivation, that is very effective motivation and done by the experts. So this, in this, the consciousness is affected and this is mostly used by the expert. Music, when we listen music, so that also allow us to do various works concentratedly, in concentration, in try to enhance our focus, because sometimes music does not allow us to disturb our concentration by the different surrounding sounds. So the same kind of sound, the music is there that helps us to focus or concentrate on particular activity. So superstition, a widely held but irrational belief in supernatural influences. Superstitions, that is, especially as leading a good or bad luck. The persons are sometime being highly influenced by the supernatural things. They believe that luck is there, then everything will happen according to the luck. So good luck or bad luck, or a practice based on such a belief. So this way the person never believe on work and labor. They only believe on the supernatural power. So the psychological aids are there, some more than in which the practice, the techniques are there. Some performance enhancement techniques we will discuss here. the egogenic aids, psychological aids of performance enhancing, performance enhancement techniques. Mental game coaching is the segment of sports psychology that concentrates especially on helping athletes break through the mental barriers to achieve their peak potential. Sometimes we are unable to achieve whatever we deserve because of our psychological barriers, mental barriers. And these mental barriers are nothing, that is only our thinking. We have created such kind of thoughts in our mind that they become the barrier for our success. So, they improve focus and deal with distractions. In this, the technique is there. We try to improve the focus and the distractions, we deal with distractions, we try to remove the distractions by which the person is being distracted. Grow confidence in athlete who have doubts. So, in which we try to boost up the confidence of the athlete. Develop coping skills to deal with setbacks and errors. The coping skills then in which we find out the root cause and we try to overcome that. The setbacks and errors. Find the right zone of intensity for your sports. To instill a healthy belief system and identify irrational thoughts. So healthy beliefs should be developed, and we try to develop the healthy beliefs in the mind of the athlete, and irrational thoughts, and identify the irrational thoughts which are trying to disturb the person. Improve or balance motivation for optimal performance. So motivation is also highly effective. Develop confidence post injury. In case of injury, then after the injury we develop confidence among the athletes, then they can recover quickly and they can save next time from the injuries, and whatever fear is there, we can try to remove that fear. Mechanical aids are there. Next one we will discuss mechanical aids, egogenic aid, like clothings, equipments. Clothing means what type of clothing can help us to perform well, because that's why there is the dress code in each sports and games. Equipment should be in good quality. Heat and cold application. This is also used like recovery from the injuries. Heat and cold applications. Improve body mechanics. Body mechanics, then the biomechanics in which body movements are used, technical body movements are used to perform well in sports activities. The use of one's body to produce motion that is safe, energy conserving and efficient, all of which allow the person to maintain balance and control. So mechanical aids are there. The use of one's body to produce motion that is safe, energy conserving and efficient, all of which allow the person to maintain balance and control. And another one is environment, playing condition and surface. These are the mechanical egogenic aids. Then we will see pharmacological egogenic aids. Pharmacological एगोजेनिक एड्स आर देयर ओवर द काउंटर ड्रग्स, दीज आर नोन एज ओटीसी ऑल्सो, ओटीसी ड्रग्स. ओटीसी ड्रग्स ओवर द काउंटर ड्रग्स आर देयर, दीज ड्रग्स आर सोल्ड डायरेक्टली टू द कंज्यूमर विदाउट प्रिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ अ डॉक्टर. एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल डायरेक्टली गो टू द काउंटर्स और द मेडिकल काउंटर्स, मेडिकल शॉप्स एंड परचेज दीज medicines or drugs. So OTC drugs, these are known as OTC drugs, over to counter, over the counter means they are directly sold from the counter without prescription. Over the counter drugs are medicines sold directly to the consumer without a prescription from a healthcare professional or doctors, etc. These are caffeine, nicotine, amphetamines, melatonin, various OTC drugs are there. So increased mental alertness and concentration, they use the to increase the mental alertness and concentration. Central nervous system is stimulated by the these kind of drugs and medicine. They elevate mood, they decrease fatigue, and they improve muscular strength. The pharmacological aids are there. Pharmacologically, these drugs are the medicines. Drugs or medicines are there, which we have discussed in substances. Various prohibited substances. Some of the prohibited substances are also available, but the prohibited substances, other than the prohibited substances, other substances and drugs are also available over the counter as OTC drugs. The recreational pharmacological drug aids we will discuss then. There is recreational drug. Recreational drugs are mind alerting chemicals, substances that are used for medicinal purpose. Leisure purpose means whenever the person is, leisure is known as free time. Taking a substance for a sole purpose of getting high, like alcohol, marijuana, cocaine, these are the recreational drugs considered as used for recreation. And when the person do not have any work, they have free time, then these person think about to use of these kind of drug. So these are also the prohibited substances. But we are discussing about ergogenic aids. So some of the ergogenic aids are also illegal, like this we are discussing. So prescription drug, another one is prescription drug. So these are drugs which are used by the prescription of the doctor. Prescription drugs is a pharmaceutical drug that legally required a medical prescription to be dispensed. These are used for life saving. These are used for the saving of the life of a person. These are used for various treatment of various diseases and ailments. So these are known as the prescription drugs. So these are also the pharmacological ergogenic aids. Next is physiological aids. Physiological ergogenic aids are there. These are the drugs. These are the methods like blood doping and substances like EPO. Blood doping we have discussed. Erythropoietin, EPO. The primary role of erythropoietin is red blood cells production in body. We have discussed about EPO in detail. Altitude training means the training is in high altitude. Altitude training is the training for several weeks at high altitude, preferably over 2400 meter to 8000 feet or above the sea level, for endurance. So high altitude, the training is given to make the physiological system highly strong and adaptable to work in the critical situations. The effect of altitude training on body include an increase of endurance, reduces recovery time, weight loss, etc. Glycerol for keeping the body hyper and hydrate. Then the nutritional aid. Nutritional ergogenic aids are there. Bee pollen, the pollen grains, bee pollen. Carbohydrate loading, being loaded with carbohydrate. Coenzyme, Q10. These are helping to fulfill the requirement of enzyme in body. Creatine phosphate, CP. The CP is known as instant energy for the muscles. Creatine phosphate. This is short form, and CP also it is known. Water for special beverage or special beverage, water or special beverages. Water, we know that is the best source of nutrient, minerals especially. Special beverages like coffee, tea and other energy drinks. So nutritional aids we will discuss detail here, like bee pollen, mixture of vitamins, minerals, amino acids and other nutrients. Thought to improve performance. They are good to improve the performance. Bee pollen, in which this is the in honeycomb also we found the bee, and this is the mixture of the honeycomb and pollen grains. The mixture of vitamins, minerals and amino acids and other nutrients. So this is good for improving the performance of the individual. Carbohydrate loading means the practice of eating high amount of carbohydrate sometime after a period of low carbohydrate intake for several days. When we do not have sufficient carbohydrate to eat for several days, so we need to practice to load our body with carbohydrate highly immediately before competing in an athletic event, especially a marathon, in order to store glycogen in the body, thereby providing greater reserve of energy. So carbohydrate should be sufficient in body, that is known as carbohydrate loading. Coenzyme, that is ubiquinone, Q10. It is used for energy production by every cell in our body and is therefore vital for good health, high energy level, longevity and general quality of life. It facilitates the aerobic metabolism as part of the electron transport chain and classified as a vitamin. And water as a special beverage, then we will discuss this about next video.